Mike.
How to build an app with Ionic and Amplify. First, I will start with a small introduction. I started coding in the 80s on a Commodore VIC-20 when I was around 12 years old. And I still love coding. I'm very enthusiastic about Ionic already since 2015, so almost from the beginning. I'm a front-end developer and I work for Trivento, a software company in the Netherlands for smart solutions. Also, Mike mentioned already, I co-founded Dayclocks, a smart clock for connecting generations via an app on your mobile device. You can send messages and pictures to a day clock to reassure your parents or grandparents. For example, you can make an appointment to have some coffee or just send some pictures of your children. The agenda for this half an hour. I'm going to talk about Amplify. Why Amplify? A small introduction into Amplify Studio. I will give a live demo and we'll end with some final thoughts. Why? Why Amplify? Trivento asked me to work on a new web application for monitoring levels of soil water. And of course, no doubt about it, I started with Ionic. But a colleague of mine went to the event conference of Amazon last November, and he was very enthusiastic about Amplify Studio. The main reason for choosing Amplify Studio was the low-code part. Low-code is a visual approach to software development that optimizes the entire development process to accelerate delivery. So for new projects, we could focus more on business logic instead of coding boilerplate. So that looks very interesting to us. So let's tell me more about this park application. The app will assist a city to monitor the health of trees, bushes, etc. in a park. This will be done by sensors which measuring the level of soil water. It will be used by landscapers of the park, but also by staff employees of the city. So we need a mobile application and a desktop application. So I proposed the following stack. Of course, at first, capacitor, because capacitor lets you deploy to iOS and Android. And of course, the amazing new plugins like Google Maps. And also we're going to use Amplify Studio for the generating the UI and the backend. AppFlow, I'm a huge fan of AppFlow, especially the live updates component. So we can easily update our app without the App Store or Play Store. You can immediately send updates or bug fixes, etc. Very awesome. And at last, we're using React. It's a library, not a framework, for building the UI interfaces. And I'll give a small demo of this app. This is the main screen. You see the city of Amsterdam and with some markers of in a park, for example, the Vondelpark. And this is just the mock data, which is to give you a view of the working of the application. For example, the water level is 50%, the degree is 12. And with the new plugin of Google Maps, it's really fast, another map. And like I mentioned, we have also a special screen for the city workers. And because we also need a desktop application, I can go to the main screen of a desktop and you see the same application in for a desktop application. Over here, you can add extra information about the sensors, and you can click to have some information about the sensors, etc. So that works perfectly fine. Amplify Studio. What's Amplify Studio? Amplify Studio is a visual interface that allows developers to easily build and ship complete web and mobile apps in hours. You can quickly build a backend and frontend and create React components. Amplify Studio consists of the following components: UI library, which you can create with Figma your own interfaces, UI components, and default, the standard components. You can have a data backend, you can create your own content. Of course, you have authentications, and you can host your application to the Amazon Cloud. This is the main screen of Amplify Studio. You have the different components like content, UI library, data. And later on, during the demo, it will be more clear. Nowadays, design to code is a hot topic, especially for designers. Figma is a very popular tool. And with UI library, you can create React components straight out of your Figma tool, Figma file. This is the main screen of the UI library, and you can just import your Figma file to create your components. But I will be showing it also in the demo. How does it work? Duplicate the Amplify Amazon design. Of course, you have a complete set of components, for example, an authenticator, a chatbot, storage, but also relationships. For example, a sensor belongs to a park and what belongs to a city, etc. Next, content. The content component provides a tabular view of the backend data, and so you can manually add your own data, of course, but also you can generate content just for mock purposes. Now this is an example of the content of the tabular view. For example, Deventer, the most beautiful city of the Netherlands. Deventer is a city in the east part of the Netherlands. Very beautiful. Mike, maybe I suggest you can come over to Deventer beginning of June. Also, next to the tabular view, also you can bind a UI component, UI data to the UI components. So that's also really nifty. For example, you have a section card component, and you can bind this to the content model. Authentication. With authentication, you can create sign in and sign up workflows to your app. In a few lines of code, can use email or Facebook or Google, all automated for you. This is the page how you can configure your login, your email. You have multi-factor authentication is also possible. A nice feature. And at last, you can, of course, host your application to the Amazon Cloud. It's fully managed CI/CD, secure, fast, and reliable. This is the screen of the hosting. You can see you can just connect to your repository, and then you can build and deploy your application. The nice part of using the Amazon Cloud also is not part of Amplify Studio, but you can use AWS Recognition. This is the machine learning part of Amazon, and this part you can use for recognize faces, and I have a really nice demonstration of this. It can identify objects, people, texts, and activities. Facial analysis and face comparison. But now it's time for a real nice demo. Before I start, also the installation and configuration of Amplify is very easy. With npm install Amplify CLI, you can start make the installation of the CLI. Amplify configure, you can configure your project, etc. And you can install your components at your backend. Just very easy. Okay, demo time. Let's go to the environment. At first, I will show you the backend. Now it's loading all the models. As you see, I have different models, content, model for park, sensors, and a model for city. And you can add fields, for example, location, etc. It's self-explanatory, very easy. Then if I switch over to the content, it's fetching the items. This is the table content. I can add some create content. So it's added. That's nice. If I go to the UI library component, first, I will show the components. So I have just a few sample components. I will first one more time back. I can configure. I can connect it to a table. I can select a data model. And if I select the label, I can add the label and the value, or in that case, content description. I can shuffle. Now it's generating random data, so I can toggle it. So that's very nice. Now I'm just created, continue with the current model, but if I just, it's a little bit scary, of course. If I just remove all components, I can sync with the Figma file. It's just an ordinary Figma file. I create a now. I can accept all the updates, and the components are back. And now I can configure data model, select the property. Now we're back. So it's very easy to generate your UI and your backend. You can also take a look at your code. This will be generated, how you can use it, and you can, this command, you can pull your information, your code, and you're done. And it will generate a GraphQL API. You can also pull your information, your code for the backend, and you are done. So this will conclude my Amplify Studio demo. Then I will throw in some magic. Detect faces. Like I mentioned, with the Amazon module recognition, you have can detect key facial features, for example, your nose and mouth, and you can detect 100 faces in one image. And last April, we organized in the Netherlands an Ionic meetup, and I asked them to use, we made a group picture, and I asked them to use this picture for the for a special demonstration. I have a live demo for it. I can select a picture. If you wait a moment, it will estimate the ages of all the members, all the people on this picture. Final thoughts. Now with Amplify Studio, you can ship full stack in a few application in a few days. But I want to have more experience with real world projects, maybe bigger projects to have what are the possibilities of Amplify Studio. But it works great with Ionic products such as Capacitor and AppFlow, especially you have the need for an application, a desktop application, and a mobile application. So in other words, it's the best of both worlds, I think. Thank. And if you have questions, you can ask me on Discord, via Twitter or LinkedIn. Thanks.